Hi, I'm Deanna Dunn. I teach at Battleground Elementary School, and this is me.
Beyond the numbers, scores, grades, and wins and losses, Lincoln County Schools desires to showcase real people, local families, real struggles, successes, and real stories that are part of our own untold story. This is a great place to work, learn, play, and grow, and we want our community to see the strength from our own. We are hashtag LCS strong to the core.
Deanna, you are a survivor.
I am.
What does that mean to you? You survived what?
I survived cancer. I survived a change. I survived a change of life.
Talk about what cancer you had.
I had triple negative breast cancer.
Which means what?
It means that normally you can take some medicine when you're finished with your treatment. There's not any after this one. You just hope and pray that you're done.
Mm. And you are through treatments?
I'm through treatments, yes. Finished my radiation August 21st of last year.
And this cancer to you when you were diagnosed really is not even a full year, year old diagnosis at this point, right?
Right.
So it's relatively new. So talk about some of the highs and lows and the emotional roller coaster that cancer puts you through. Talk about some of that if you don't mind.
You know, just like everyone else, you think you're okay and you're gonna be just fine. I wanted everybody to be normal. That was the biggest thing.
Mm-hmm.
And when I came back to school, people were like, oh, take some time off, do what you need to do. And I was like, what I need to do is be with my kids. These are my support, you know, people, like my support staff.
Mm-hmm.
They are there every day for me. They checked in with me. They wanted to see my head without hair on it, which was fine, but I never realized how losing my hair was gonna affect me.
Mm.
And they were right there. It's okay.
Because you used to have a very big head of hair.
Yes.
And to go from that to bald, I mean, that's definitely changed your appearance in a lot of ways. But how did you talk to your kids about what you were going through with the struggle? Because you continue to work through all this.
I did. But I came in, and it was November, so I didn't tell them right away. But then I sat them all down. We have carpet time in the morning, like for morning meeting. And I said, guys, I'm sick. I'm going to have to go through some things.
You're good.
I'm good.
Yeah, you are good.
And you're going to see it because it's going to be right in front of you. And some of them said, why don't you quit working? And I was like, because I need you guys.
Mm.
Got to get my Kleenex.
Oh, yeah.
But they helped me. I mean, there are mornings I couldn't get up. But I knew I'd have to come and work with them. And I was like, yes, we'll go. So.
Talk about during that time, you talked about your kids or your support. Support staff, if you will, but what did the staff at Battleground mean to you during this time as well?
They were amazing. I had stuff in my box from people I didn't even see every day.
Mm-hmm.
They, you know, I was able to go home when I needed to. They would come down my door and see if I was here because they didn't want me to get infected for the flu. They were watching me all the time. The kids, what we changed in the classroom for sure. I had a huge bottle of sanitizer, and everybody that walked in my room would sanitize when they came in and sanitize when they went out. And it was just a thing. When I went to meetings, they would sanitize in and sanitize out. So they cared. They wanted to help me through. And that's a big part of getting there.
How did the outpouring of your staff and the outpouring of your kids change how you teach?
Well.
Or did it?
No, it didn't change it. Majorly because I always involve my kids with what I did. They need to know what the world's about. And I always made it real to them. When we had an argument, we need to sit down and figure out why we're talking like that way to each other.
Mm.
I didn't ever keep secrets from the kids. You know, sometimes we were having something special, and I kind of give them a heads up because some were anxious, some were nervous, and they appreciated that. They're like, oh, Miss Dunn, I can sit by you because I knew I didn't like loud noises.
Mm.
And so I just always included my kids, and I didn't think to not include them. You know, I included the fifth or fourth grade mostly because that's who I saw. That's mm-hmm. my position was to work fourth grade most. But my other kids learned, and the counselor went around and talked to different classes and said, "This is what's going on," and shared some things about it. And if you want to ask Miss Dunn, go ask her. And I wanted everybody to be able to ask me questions.
Make it comfortable for them. Because in elementary, it's a little different trying to explain what that is.
It is. It is. And we went everywhere and talked to the kids. And I would get down low for kindergarten and share with them what was going on. And I told them, I said, this is just temporary. But I'm going to change because I have turbans. And then I went to wigs.
Very fashionable with that too, yes.
I really enjoyed that part. And now here it is. It's growing back finally.
So, you know, thinking about what cancer did to your body, now what is that? What has cancer done for your ability to be an advocate for awareness?
Oh, the interesting part is every time I hear someone have cancer, I immediately find them if they're close to us or if I know of them. I mean, I'm not going off, you know, searching for them. But when somebody's brother or somebody's mom or somebody's person that they're married to or just them have something, I like to talk to them just to encourage them. And I don't give too much information because everybody's journey is their own. And if they call and specifically ask a question, I'll be glad to talk to them about it. But all I do is pray and support them.
So, you know, part of that prayer and support and encouragement and just what you were able to overcome with your body, all those are hallmarks of what it means to be strong. And Miss Ely nominated you because she felt you were the embodiment of strength at Battleground. Do you think you're strong, Deanna?
Yes, in certain ways. There's a lot of times when I'm weak, but that's usually when I'm home, you know, all alone. But for others, I tend to step up and say, we're going to take care of it. We're going to do just fine. And that was my whole attitude. You know, we're gonna get through this. I did prepare myself, though, in case I didn't. But, yeah, I am strong.
How are you forecasting what's next for you in your life now that you've been changed by cancer?
I'm taking the year to try to get back to what I think is normal. And then after that, who knows? I plan to do whatever I want.
There you go. Well, thank you for being a part of our storytelling of people's journeys, but also of their opportunity to be strong for students, but also for staff in this community. If you had one opportunity now to say for whatever you wanted to whomever you wanted to, that helped you through your journey outside of Battleground, Lincoln community, Lincoln County, anybody, now's your time. What do you want to say?
To all my friends and family, thank you. I appreciate it.
Thanks for being a part of our journey.
Thank you. Thank you for letting me share a small part of my story. I'm proud to be a part of #LCS Strong to the Core.